So good day. In the last video, I've explained about the capacitance of the capacitors. So now we're going to talk about capacitors in series and in parallel. And then we're going to look into the energy store in the capacitor. So first, we look through the learning outcome of this video. So at the end of this video, you should be able to derive and use the formula of the effective capacitance. And then you should have learned about the formula of the energy. So first, we look into the capacitors in series. So in the last video, so we have seen how a single capacitor are charged by the battery. So the electron flow from the negative terminal of the battery to charge one of the plate of the capacitor, and then induce a positive charge on another plate. So this process will continue on until all the capacitors are charged. So we have the formula of Q equal to CV. So there are three parameters here that we should carefully observe. So first thing is about the charge. So you can see that the capacitors in series are having the same charge. So based on these observations, so we can calculate the potential difference across each of the capacitor by using the formula of V equal to Q over C. So you could see that the potential difference of the capacitor is inversely proportional to the capacitance of the capacitors. So, and then I want you to recall back things you learned in STPM Physics about the resistors in the series circuit. So you could see that the potential difference across each of the capacitors, their sums are equal to the EMF of the battery. So we can use this information again to do the derivations. So we start with the formula of V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. And then you substitute all the formulas of the V. Then you divide the equations with Q. So you could get effective capacitance of the capacitors in series is equal to 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 plus 1 over C3. So next, we're going to look into the capacitors in parallel. So we have, let's say, three capacitors in parallel. So you have learned that for the components in parallel, okay, they are having equal potential difference, which in this case, they will equal to the EMF of the battery. So the battery will charge each of the capacitors until all the capacitors having the same potential difference. So to calculate the charge on each of the capacitors, so we can use the formula of Q equal to CV, where V is the EMF value of the battery. So you could see that the charge that can be stored in the capacitor is depending on the capacitance of the capacitor, which defined as the capability of the capacitor to store the charge. And then we were interested to calculate the total charge in all the capacitors. So using the formula of Q equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So you substitute the formula for each of the Q, and then you divide them with V. So in the end, you could find that the effective capacitance is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. So after we have learned about how we can calculate the effective capacitance of capacitors in series and parallel, so now I would like you to recall back what you have learned in the STPM Physics about the resistors. So to analyze or to derive the effective resistance or the capacitors, so the steps are actually almost the same. So first, we need to identify the constant variable, where the constant variable for the parallel circuit of the resistor and capacitors are showing the same properties, where the voltage is the same for each of the components in parallel. So you could compare the series circuit where the current in resistors are the same, while in capacitors that are connected in series, they are having the same charge instead of the current, since capacitors do not allow the direct current to flow through. So next, we observe the starter pack to do the derivations. So in the series circuit of the resistor or the capacitors, they start using the same formula of V equal to V1 plus V2 plus, etc. But for in parallel circuit, so we will add all the current for the resistor circuit, but we add all the charge for the capacitor connected in the parallel. So then we do the substitution for each of the formula, and then you could get the effective value for each of the components in different circuit. So from here, you could see that the formula to calculate the effective resistance in series is actually the same as the capacitor in parallel. While the resistor in parallel, the way to calculate the effective resistance is the same as to calculate the effective capacitance of capacitors connected in series. So now I'm going to look at a special case that when the capacitors are charged. So what happens if we disconnect the battery from the capacitors? So let's start with the series circuit. So when we disconnect the battery from the capacitor, so you could see that the capacitors are in open circuit. So up to this point, there's no changes happen here. But there's one interesting happen when you connect the one end of the capacitor to the other end of the capacitors. So when they are joined together, so you could see that the negative charge of C3 can discharge the positive charge on C1. And then the process repeated again between the C1 and C2. And then you keep repeating until all the capacitors are discharged. So when you have a series circuit that have disconnected battery and they are joined together, so the charge will be discharged to zero. And then the potential difference across all the capacitors become zero. Next, we look at the parallel circuit of capacitors. So when you disconnect the battery from the capacitors, so as you can see that there's no way for the negative charge of the capacitor could discharge the positive charge on the other plate. So for the parallel circuit of the capacitors, the charge is remain constant and the V is also constant. So now I'm going to increase the difficulties of this case where you could add an uncharged capacitor to the charged capacitor. So please remember that components in parallel should have equal potential difference. So what is happening here is that the three capacitors on top will become a temporary battery to charge the fourth capacitor at the bottom. So they will do the charge redistributions so that all the capacitors are having the same potential difference. So bear in mind that there is no increase in total charge. So the charge is conserved in this case. So let us do one example for this case. So let's say the total charge in this case is 24 coulombs and the capacitance for each of the capacitor is given as 1, 2, 3, and 4 farad. So the information given here are the capacitance and also the total charge in the capacitor before the connection of the uncharged capacitor. So what we are going to find is the final potential difference across each of the capacitor after the charge redistributions. And so we're going to find the final charge on each of the capacitor. So to solve these questions, so the first thing we can do is to determine the new effective capacitance with the new capacitors. And then using the effective capacitance, so with the charge conserved, so you could get the final potential difference using the formula of Q over C, then you will get 2.4 volt in this case. So lastly, you can apply the formula of Q equal to CV to obtain the charge for each of the capacitor. So if you add all the charge here from Q1 to Q4, you will get the value of 24 coulombs, which is correct that the charge is conserved. So if you understand what is happening around here, so I would give you one example for you to try to solve. So based on the parallel circuit that I have discussed, so now we're going to replace the capacitor in parallel into the capacitor in series. So before we remove the battery, so you are given with the EMF of the battery, which is equal to 24 watts. And then the capacitance for each of the capacitors are 2, 3, and 6 farad. So please calculate the total charge of capacitors. So and then we're going to remove the battery and replace with an uncharged capacitor, which is given as 5 farad. So from here, please find three things for me. First is the final potential difference of 5 farad capacitor. And then please find the charge for each of the capacitor. And lastly, please find the potential difference across C1, C2, and C3. So I will provide the answer maybe a few days later after the video. So you can try it yourself and then you could share your answer in the comment section below. So we can have further discussion there if you still have any problems. So before we end the discussion, so we're going to look into the energy store in charged capacitor. So for this topic, you are not required to study about the derivations, but only to use the formula. So the energy store in the capacitors, so I personally would only remember the formula of U equal to half CV squared. So the second and third formula can be obtained using the formula of Q equal to CV to do the substitutions. So another thing you need to know is the energy supply by the battery, or sometimes the question was mentioned about the work done to charge the battery. So the work done is equal to QV. So if you compare the energy stored in the capacitor and the work done to charge the battery, you will find out that the energy stored in the capacitor is less than the work done. So this indicates that there is energy loss as heat energy during the charging of the capacitor, which can be calculated by the equation of W minus U. So that's conclude my discussion for today. So if you have done the exercise just now, so you can leave it in the comment section below. So if you have any questions, you can leave also in the comment section. And also please do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.